With another video. This is going to be a video all about my e-collar. I've had a lot of requests for this specifically, so I decided to film it. First, I use the Mini Educator. I believe it's the ET300. When you get it, you get the remote and the receiver. You also get a booklet and some replacement little prongs, and you also get a like lanyard you can put your remote on. Start off, I'm going to talk a little bit about the remote. This is what the remote looks like. On the back, you pull this up. This is how you charge it. This, you hold this button on to turn it on and off. You press it lightly once, it turns on a blinking light. Then you press it again to turn on a solid light. Then you hit it again to turn off the light. This M/C button just changes it between modes, but honestly, I only keep it on the original mode. So this T right here is the vibration button. This red S is, if you hold it down, it gives a continuous stimulation. And this black one, no matter how long you hold it down, it gives one little pop of a stimulation. Okay, so this is obviously the antenna. This dial, if you can see the blue light, changes it. The setting, it has 100 settings. This will light green when it's connected to the receiver. So you turn the receiver on by connecting this red dot to this red dot, like so, and then that just turned red. If you can see, it'll turn green to turn on. These are like the probes kind of that you have to put against your pet's skin so they can feel it. This is where you charge it. This will light up green when it's connected to the remote and when it gets a stimulation. And the band is replaceable. The thickness of fur and how much your dog has definitely will affect the setting that they can first start feeling it at. One of the questions I get asked most frequently is, does Wesley's fur/hair interfere with the probes and stimulation? So, yes. My trainer is the one who found out his starting level for me, and at the time he was, I think, almost exactly 5 months, and his starting level was 12, which is unlikely for puppies. But that's what he started at, and for anyone who does not know, you can tell if your dog feels it by just if they turn their head, they flick their ear usually. It's something as small as that. You don't want them to whine or cry or let out like a big shout like right away. It's expected they will make a noise like that at higher levels, like 80 or above, or for more sensitive dogs, even lower. Stay. Good boy. Also, I'm practicing downstays with Wesley as I'm filming this, so if you see me adjusting, that's why. As a disclaimer, because I know someone's gonna comment on it or someone's gonna message me about it on Instagram, a lot of people do recommend waiting until at least 6 months to start with a correction tool. Wesley and I started with this e-collar at 5 months. I felt it was necessary to start with a correction tool. I'll explain why in a moment. But my trainer, who is a very highly rated and ranked trainer who trains working dogs, after the evaluation, he said he believes that Wesley was good to go with this, and if anything during the first lesson went wrong with it, then he would take him off of it immediately. But I trusted him and it worked out great. I say this collar literally changed my life. Anyone who knows me through Instagram or in real life knows that puppyhood was really hard for me. I know Wes is still a puppy, but I'm talking about like really young, because Wes was and still is more rambunctious. He used to bite and nibble at everything, which I know is normal, but as my first dog at all, it was very hard for me to deal with. And I just got frustrated myself that I couldn't get him to stop. He was doing all puppy behaviors, but I just didn't know what to do. And then he would become stubborn in some of his regular sit-down commands. So that's why I enlisted the help of a trainer sooner rather than later, and then I definitely needed a correction tool because Wesley did not understand the concept of no. Positive training works for some people, and other teams do need corrections. Everyone is entitled to their own opinion. I think all methods of training are good as long as they're safe, they're used properly. I have nothing against the positive training. I have nothing against prongs, obviously. I'm probably gonna end up using a prong in the future. So the way you use this collar is that you don't want to use it at its highest level when the dog does something like the smallest thing wrong. That's not how it works at all. So briefly, I'm just gonna try to explain how I was taught to use it. So our first training session was an hour, and it was the first time Wes and I had used the collar. Within that hour, my trainer taught Wesley how to heel perfectly, and he has healed perfectly ever since. And as you've seen in some of my Instagram videos, if you're following me there, he knows how to heel off leash as well. So basically, we started off that day, he was at a 12. And also every day kind of can be slightly different. Some days he works fine on a 5 correction, some days it needs to be like 24. And if he gets excited, because Wesley is a very excited dog, he gets overexcited really quickly. So on those days, we will go up to, I would say like a 50, 55. It depends on the situation. Also, like, obviously it depends how serious the situation is. So the first day, we had it on a 12 because that is what my trainer found his starting level to be that day. And my trainer took him on the leash. Every time Wesley got a little too far away from my trainer, he would hit this black S button, which is no matter how long you hold down the button, it only delivers one stimulation. And he would keep tapping the button, and he would stop tapping it as soon as Wesley got close enough to him that he liked. So we did that for maybe 20 minutes, and then I took over after the first few moments, and we would walk, and I would hit it. Wesley was a little surprised about it at first because he just wasn't used to the collar, which is important that you get your dog used to the collar. But after that, he was fine. And also, I just want to say that you should not let anyone online or in real life tell you what to do with your dog. Some people are really against correction tools, and while I respect their opinion, I don't think it's right for anyone to tell someone else that they're wrong or they're a bad person for using something with their dog. With this collar, Wesley has been taught to heel off-leash. His recall is amazing now, and at 7 months, I couldn't expect anything more. And I can let him off-leash, and I'm confident that he'll come back with even a level 3 reminder. Like, he knows what to do. And I'm not saying that I use a correction every time. That's just saying, like, if he runs off somewhere, like, hypothetically, if he ever ran off and I needed to get him and I needed a correction, I could use that. Now he doesn't need corrections when he walks. He hasn't needed a correction when he walks. Sometimes I'll use slight corrections when we're doing PA training if he gets a little too far. What these stimulations are is it's really just like a little tap on the shoulder for them. Now I'm just gonna show you how to put the collar on. Okay, come on, come. Come, sit. Sit. Okay, ready? Get dressed. Good boy. You want it to be right behind their ears, all the way up on their neck, and you want it to be tight. Want a treat? Okay, come. Sit. So if you can see, you should only be able to fit 2 fingers under. It should be tight, and you want to make sure that when you put it on, the probes are not caught on any fur or hair. You want it to be directly on the skin. So if you have to like wiggle it around kind of to get directly to the skin. Hi guys, okay, so we're working at a 10 right now, and I just wanted to show you guys how I use it. So every time I say tap, it's when I'm hitting the button. I'm hitting the black S
which is not the continuous, so it only gives like one kind of ping of a stimulation. So he's off leash healing right now. We're in our court. So yeah, okay, heal. As you can see, he doesn't need too many corrections, so I'm gonna try to turn and we'll see. Heal. Oh, okay. Heal, tap. Good boy. If you see him shake his head, that's how he reacts when he hits things. I'm gonna lower it to a 7 now. Tap, tap, tap. Good boy, good puppy, good puppy. You can see he's still smiling, he's still happy, he's not hurt in any way. Sit. Say hi. Wes, watch me. Watch me. Good boy. Also, one more thing I forgot to add, the mini educator is water resistant, waterproof up to a certain distance, so you can give your dogs baths in them, they can go swimming in them, and yeah.
Thanks guys for watching another video. As always, leave recommendations or any suggestions you have down below. Waiting until
E1, you see Wes. This is a vibration. This is a continuous stimulation.